Powell needed to do the 180. He did. They codified what they'd said in early January, reinforced what we thought was going to happen after the January FOMC meeting, and they've definitely doubled down. The market, though, Scott, is still looking for the next move to be a cut. So the Fed's moving in the right direction, but rates, to me, have to go lower, and the curve has to be steeper.
Yeah. Hey, Ed Yardeni, how do you see it now? Is this the best of what could have happened yesterday, or maybe even better than people expected?
Well, for the stock market, it was a joyous occasion for sure. It kind of puzzles me, to tell you the truth. You know, only a few months ago, the Fed folks were talking about 2, 3, 4 rate hikes this year. Mm-hmm. Now they've said nothing, no increases at all this year. I want to get a neck brace here for this change of view. Look, I think from a pragmatic standpoint, what puzzles me is it would make sense that maybe later this year you might want to raise the rate. The more basis points you have between the Fed funds rate and zero, the better next time you have a recession. But no, that went all out the window. Not only that, but they really didn't downgrade the economy that much or the inflation outlook that much. But they did downgrade the Fed funds outlook and the dot plot. And they told us, don't look at that dot plot anymore. But how could you take your eyes off of it when it goes to a flat outlook for interest rates?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Kari, we know that the pivot from Powell has been powerful.
Yeah.
And it's really meant everything since the end of December. We put up a wall, and we can show it again as we have this conversation, just how dramatic the moves have been. You know, the pivot that Powell made, not only on the mm-hmm. path of rates, but also on the balance sheet. And this is borne out here, where you can see when they made certain moves, November 28th, the target rate just below neutral, you get the S&P pop, and then subsequent moves based on that. And from January 4th, the final pivot until now, mm-hmm. the S&P's up double digits, 15 or 16%.
Right.
So this did nothing to upset what you would have wanted if you're bullish the market.
No, correct. I would say that in contrast to Steve's point that nothing has changed, I think there are a couple of things that have changed in terms of interest rates. We've seen interest rates go from 3.2 to 2.5, and the dollar has also come down. To the extent that that is good for buyers of dollars overseas, it helps foreign economies, and it will make bonds less competitive internally, and it probably will help the market multiple. I mean, that's positive for market multiples. It's probably positive for multinationals. If we think that the dollar is going to stay down for a while, it helps their businesses. There's been fear of this earnings recession less likely to happen, particularly in the second half.
Dollar is cheaper. Right? The dollar went below its 200-day moving average. There is, though, now, Pete, a debate in the market. We call it the great debate. So you've got Scott Minard, right, of Guggenheim, says it's time to take some profits as a recession looms. I mean, yes, the Fed is your friend. It underscored that yesterday.
Yep.
But in taking down the economy, it also shows you what the risks are. Then there's Tom Lee, who says there's a lot of gas left in the tank, that we're mid-cycle. We're not even as late as some people think. What do you think?
I think I lean more towards Tom, but not quite to the level of that kind of enthusiasm. I mean, we've been talking about this for a while, Scott. This is a trading environment. It's been a great trading environment. So I don't know necessarily that you're going in to sell and saying that I'm not going to shift yourself around, because we are still in a position where this is a rotating environment of what we see in the market right now. I mean, that rotation has been, energy was out of favor. Now it's been back in favor for the last couple of weeks. And look at it today with oil over 60, the XLE, and many of those different names that are in there have been moving to the upside. Yesterday, we highlighted ExxonMobil. There are multiple of those beta names are really moving to the upside. But then you've got technology. Then you've got the semiconductors. So we have rotated. Now, all of a sudden, you're losing the financials because of what happened yesterday with Powell and the patience and everything they're talking about. So we're losing the financials right now. After that big run, I mean, I talked about Goldman Sachs on Monday. This is a stock that was 205 that's now trading, what, 193, something like that. JP Morgan was 108, and that's fallen back as well. So, yes, the financials are getting hurt by this, but this rotation continues, and I think that's healthy.